You're watching UNICEF Television. Here in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, a country the size of Western Europe, there is only around 2,800 kilometers of paved roads, most in severe disrepair. Dirt tracks lead everywhere else. Navigating this spiderweb of informal tracks is the main challenge facing DR Congo's efforts to eliminate maternal neonatal tetanus, or MNT. But through the determined efforts and teamwork of local drivers and health workers, the country is slowly succeeding. Globally, MNT claims the life of one newborn baby every 9 minutes. Working with UNICEF, who has partnered with Pampers since 2006 to eliminate MNT, DR Congo has rolled out a pervasive vaccination network to ensure every woman of childbearing age is immunized against the killer disease. The procurement of vaccines triggers the start of a complex but essential process. In the country's southern Katanga province, the rollout begins in the regional capital, Lubumbashi. Here, vaccines flown in from the capital, Kinshasa, are packed into cooler boxes, the first step in a vaccine-preserving cold chain process, and then loaded onto pickups. Hughes Cape is one of the drivers and spends much of his life ferrying the delicate vials to all of Katanga's 19 district health centers and travels distances of up to 400 kilometers.
La route est mauvaise et la route n'est pas est en terre bâtie.
The roads are bad. It's usually all dirt roads and there are a lot of potholes. And you often find that bridges have collapsed, so you have to drive through the water to get to the health center.
Pour arriver à la destination.
Hughes delivers today's batch of vaccines to the Kipushi District Health Center, which in turn supplies them to 22 community health centers and clinics scattered throughout the district. The vaccines are added to the inventory and measured against the needs of each health center. Even as the vaccines are cataloged, health workers from the community health centers begin to arrive by bicycle to collect the new batches. Guy Bakatumaka arrives from the Kaniaka Health Center, 30 kilometers away. He signs for his precious cargo, secures it, and begins the journey back. Many of the health workers will spend up to 4 days on a round trip, covering distances of up to 300 kilometers. On his arrival at the Kaniaka Health Center, the vaccines are unpacked, the register opened, and the syringes prepared. It's prenatal day, and every pregnant woman who comes to the clinic is vaccinated against tetanus. Even those who are reluctant are soon convinced. Emmanuel Kalwazi's role is to overcome any religious or cultural barriers. He's the chief nurse here and has never seen a baby survive tetanus.
Most women give birth at home. If they get contractions and deliver at home, and the midwife doesn't use sterilized equipment, if the mother is not vaccinated against tetanus, there is a chance that the baby will be infected and the prognosis will be death.
Globally, the lives of 130 million women and their babies living in the hardest-to-reach areas of the world's most underprivileged countries are at risk for MNT. To reach even them, Emmanuel and his team provide outreach to distant villages. Emmanuel lectures villagers on the need for vaccination and calls forward all the pregnant women. Fani Kibwe is one of them. She will most likely deliver at home, a prime situation for contracting tetanus.
For me, it's very important to get vaccinated during pregnancy so that me and my child are protected against diseases. Here in DR Congo, there are so many epidemics, which is why I need to get vaccinated every single time.
Vaccinations continue into the afternoon. No one here knows the journey the life-saving vials have taken, or the role that people like Hughes and Guy have played in getting them to these remote villages. But they benefit because of it. Babies are born without tetanus and children grow up healthy. Pampers, in collaboration with UNICEF, is helping to protect over 100 million mothers and their babies from maternal neonatal tetanus in 25 of the world's poorest countries. By the end of 2011, several of those countries are expected to have completed their MNT campaigns. Thanks to everyone who supports partners like Pampers to donate vaccines, UNICEF can continue to help protect those women and children most in need. You've been watching UNICEF Television. For more information, go to unicef.org. Unite for Children.